From every edge of Music City, from some of the finest bedrooms and basements in town, Music City Roots is on the air. And keeping with social distancing best practices during these challenging times, the show must go on, and it must go on online. So tonight, in this one-time-only webcast, you'll hear some of our classic Music City Roots artists, singers, songwriters, and musicians who've become part of our family over the past 10 years, including our old friend and musical host, a man who must be getting a lot of songwriting done with all his free time. Welcome, Jim Lauderdale!
Good imagination, no one else can see. It's like a three-way conversation between you and you and me. You always speak to me in color, vivid as the day is long, and I could listen to you talking till the rest. Recognition traveling up and down my spine, or a little piece of the premonition that got mixed up with mine. There's lots of different kinds of people, it's best not to interrupt, just leave them to their own devices. That's so easy.
Missed that voice so much. Look at that, guys.
One of the great songwriters, Jim Lauderdale, folks.
Yeah.
Thanks so much.
Absence makes the heart grow fonder. If I can become any more fond of you, I am.
Well, same here. I have really missed you guys. I've missed you folks out there. And thanks so much for joining us tonight. And I've got to say, Keith, we've done literally hundreds of Music City Roots shows.
Yeah, well, it seems like hundreds anyway.
But I can't remember so many audience members showing up in pajamas.
Look at them. And they think we can't see them. We can see them.
Folks, please welcome to the, please welcome to the radio podium the man who puts the show back into Schadenfreude, the awe back into award-winning radio Hall of Famer, Mr. Keith Bilbrey.
I am speechless. I am so humbled.
That feeling, it's back.
I know, it's back. To tell you the truth, I'm not going to tell you whether I have on pants or not. I may have forgotten. I don't know.
Keith, you are as incorrigible as ever. That's too much information. Cut that part out. Hey, we'll file that. Too much information. Keith, thank you. And hey, we'd like to help you get to know the artists playing on stage. And to help us with that is our interview guy.
The man.
And the man who puts the cha-cha-cha into the chat room, Mr. Craig Havigurst.
Oh, yeah.
Mr. Hey, guys. Craig. All right. Thank you very much. Yes, I'm looking forward. We've done a couple of those interviews. We've got one more to do, and we're going to put them all together and as we bring you this this evening of entertainment. And it's a thrill to be with the community and to be with you guys for sure. And we've been doing just fine here in the Melrose area of Nashville. And then, you know, taking that beer by the growlers to go. Don't forget, everybody, your independent craft tap rooms and restaurants are out there doing to-go orders. And now's the time to step up and support them. Cooking at home is good. But, you know, we've been ordering the Melrose burgers every Friday night. And it's mm-hmm. awesome. We're here tonight in support of our community and in support of two wonderful institutions that we'll be talking about through the evening. One is Music Cares, and we are going to be encouraging fundraising for Music Cares. That is the charity arm of the Recording Academy that supports musicians in times of need. They are tearing it up right now, getting mortgage assistance, rent assistance, in particular to musicians, and not just musicians, but crew members, bus members, recording engineers, front of house people, sound crew, lighting crew, everybody that makes the live music business run is in really dire straits right now. And they are helping. We will be talking to them. And we're also raising consciousness and hopefully some funds for WMRT, our great partners at Roots Radio 89.5 FM, public supported radio. Now, speaking of beer, it's time to talk about the lineup, and that's brought to you this week by Yazoo Brewing Company, wonderful, venerable national institution. We're going to be hearing from the mighty, mighty Sam Bush, founder of Newgrass and inventor of all kinds of
ways to
play on stage. But we just love Sam. He's been part of our family for many, many years, and he's going to be the wrap-up artist tonight. We're going to be hearing from Lily May, who's played the show several times, including our Runs on the Road, and just exceptional artist, one of the most unique voices in Roots music. The couple will be joining us as a duo, Sierra Hall and Justin Moses. Thank heaven they're quarantining together. And to start things off, our good old buddy, John Oates, doing his folk music thing. Before Jim introduces John for the stage, I have a few words with him just to catch up with him, see how he's doing. So let's go to John Oates in John Oates's home. John Oates, welcome to the virtual Music City Roots.
Well, may I indulge myself and say, here's Craig Havigurst.
I know I need a little Keith Bilbrey. We need a little audience. Oh my God. But they'll be out there. I'm asking everybody just a quick summary of, well, let me ask you this first. What is your last memory of normal before the abnormal? What can you like?
You know, we had the good fortune of being, we go to this event every year in Amelia Island, Florida. It's a vintage car concours d'elegance, and it's a collection of the most amazing vintage cars. And I had a car down there at the time, and it was a beautiful day in North Florida. The weather was absolutely stunning, and you know, there was like 75,000 people, and it was lots of old friends, lots of really just a wonderful weekend. And we came home from that, and that was it, pretty much. That was pretty much the last social thing we did after that. So you know, I'm really happy that we had that opportunity, and now, you know, it's a whole new reality, as we all know, and try, you know, we've been adjusting to it pretty well.
Were you going to be mostly on the road on this spring, like many artists we know, or were you?
That's another thing that we were very fortunate. We managed to get in a sold out show at Madison Square Garden with Daryl and I, on February 28th. Wow. And right after that, we went to this event that I spoke about, right, and that was it. So the fact that we, you know, and that was the kickoff of our tour, of course, you know, this amazing show at Madison Square Garden, you know, we're, you know, on cloud nine, everything was feeling so great and that we were rolling and we were going to roll right into this tour. And yes, to answer your question, we were supposed to be on tour.
So you're going to be doing the big show as opposed to the folk thing, and which you have, your life is in these seasons, I guess. Does it feel that way?
Well, it's my dual lives. You know, I put on a couple different caps and, you know, I had put on the Hall & Oates cap and I was ready to do that. And that is a big show. But at the same time, you know, in January, I got to play with my good buddies here in Nashville, the Good Road Band, with Guthrie Trapp and Steve Mackey, Josh Day, Russ Paul, Nat Smith, Sam Bush. And we got to play the Station Inn. And it was almost like kind of a, it was almost a show that we, it's like the culmination of 2 years of work with this great band and this Arkansas album that I put together.
Right. Arkansas came out in 2018. And so I was, you know, definitely going to wind up to ask you where you, what you think is next for the John Oates solo project and the Good Road Band, and when we might hear some new rootsier music from you.
Well, we had such a great time at the Station Inn, and we did it, you know, there's a video live stream of it as well. It's archived if people want to check it out. But we, the audio from it, you know, the video was okay, but the audio was really great. And so David Kalmuski over in Berry Hill at his studio by himself, of course, isolated in his little studio, he's mixing the audio. And I'd love to put out a live from Station Inn audio CD, or, you know, clip, or whatever you want to call it these days. So that's the next step for that project. And, you know, I just love playing with the Good Road Band. I love those guys. They're great friends and amazing musicians. And, you know, we will reconvene in the future with that, for sure.
What do you, I am so interested that you switch channels, and that you've had these not incompatible, but definitely two avenues of musical passion through your life, and that you've maintained both of them. I think for many, it would have been trading one for the other at some point in their career, but you've rekindled to some degree this love of folk music. And I'm just curious what these 10 years, and maybe in the context of a time when we can't all be together, you know, what does this music mean to you? What does that folk music and that American tradition, you know, you must be reflecting on it more than ever.
Well, you know, believe it or not, even though what I do with Daryl is, you know, it's known for its 80s pop and the big productions, you know, the big shows and the big arenas and things, you know, I don't see it as two distinctly different things. I mean, yes, musically, the style-wise, they're different, of course. But I see music holistically. You know, it's all about songs. I break everything down to the essence, to whatever. You know, if the song can, if I can sit here and play Man Eater on an acoustic guitar, and then I can play a Doc Watson or Mississippi John Hurt song on acoustic guitar, to me, it's really all one thing. It's just music. And, you know, I mean, without sounding too much like a cliche, there's only two kinds, good and bad. Mm-hmm. And of course, that's subjective, you know. I've got my own definition of what that might be. But regardless of that fact, you know, my experience of moving to Nashville was really what rekindled my folk roots and my blues roots and the things that I did before I met Daryl Hall. And so for me, it was like I went back to go forward in terms of my solo career. And that was really a blessing and just a thing that I can't say how grateful I am for being able to be embraced by the Americana community while still being somewhat of an outlier, you know, doing that other thing. I don't think many artists get to do that. And I don't think many artists get accepted that way. So that's something I take very seriously and I'm really, really proud of.
Great. Well, tell us what you how you thought through what you wanted to play for this particular program. What's the repertoire going to be?
It's definitely eclectic. You know, let's see. One thing I did, I wrote a new song. Daryl and I are thinking about making an album. And I wrote this song, and it's really, you know, I call it, I wrote three songs. I'm calling it the Corona Suite. Jokingly calling it the Corona Suite, because this self-isolation thing has really kind of got my creative juices going because I'm, you know, I have a chance to be not distracted by a lot of other things, to be able to really focus on things. So, you know, I did that. I did a great Mississippi John Hurt song. You know, I did Spike Driver Blues. And of course I played it on the Mississippi John Hurt guitar that I own, the one that he played at Newport in the 64. So, you know, I own that guitar now, and I tell a little story about it because I also played it on the first two Hall & Oates albums. So really there's really a lot of, you know, full circle stuff going on here. And getting back to that, I played a song called Had I Known You Better, which was on the Abandoned Luncheonette album. And I played it on the same guitar, which I played it on in 73. So that's how the show kind of, that's my little set starts off. And from there we go to all sorts of things. Let's see, I can't even remember what I played. I wish I had my set list in front of me.
That's a darn good
story. I did come up with a set list. What's that?
It's a darn good story that you've got there, though. We're that's fantastic.
Yeah, I mean, that's how we start. And then I go from there and I pick up a bunch of other Martins and Gibsons and do a bunch of stuff that I do. You know, I do my finger picking thing. I did a Don Gibson classic called Lonesome Me. Everyone knows that song. That is, and I tell a little story about that as well, because that's one of the first songs when I was a kid that I played and sang at the same time, that I was able to play the chords and sing. So that takes me back to the 50s. And so I wanted to do a version of that, and I love that song. So, you know, for me, it's all about this full circle, these full circle moments where I get to come back and kind of revisit and reimagine the stuff from my musical youth.
And we get to see a bunch of great guitars.
Yes, you do. And you also get to see a glimpse into my wife's floral design she shed down in the basement, because that's where we recorded it.
Spectacular. All right. Well, yeah. I know we're looking forward to it. John, thanks for being a part of it. Thanks for being you. You guys stay safe and be well.
Oh, same to you. I can't wait to reconvene with you guys and make music together.
Right on. See you later.
All right, man. Bye.
Well, folks, as you heard, here's an artist who let Nashville bring out the roots that helped launch an international career. He's made some great albums while living here, including the recent Arkansas. And he is, don't forget, my very close personal friend, the great John Oates.
Well, here's the title track from the last album I did here in town with the amazing Good Road Band. Shout out to all the guys. And it's called Arkansas. Thank you. This is the guitar I played on the first two Hall & Oates albums, and a little bit more on that later, but this is a song I played on the Abandoned Luncheonette album. Were you ever so in love you couldn't wait to get to sleep and dream about the one you wish was there beside you? In the past few days I've grown, love your giggles on the phone, how we hug so nicely. And from the first time that I saw you, had I known you better then, would have said those three old words. And from the first time that lightly. And from the first time that I saw you, had I known you better then, I would have said those three old words. And from the first time that I saw you, had I known you better then. Colorado, honey, to my home. Well, this next one is a Don Gibson classic, and when I was a little kid learning how to play the guitar, it's the first song that I think I played and sang at the same time. So here it is. Everybody's going out and having fun. I'm just a fool for staying home, man. I should go on out and paint the town. Lovesick fool is blind, but just can't see. Oh, lonesome me. Well, I guess she's not like me. She's out and fancy free, flirting with the boys and all her charm. But I still love her so. Brother, don't you know? This next song was inspired by my wife's family farm up in Illinois, and got to write it with my good buddy Sam Bush and another great songwriter here in town, Jeff Black. Goes a little something like this. It's called This Field Is Mine. There was a time I walked the Indian Trail, cut a road to roll the wagon wheel. Heaven knows that we worked so hard, worked too hard to fail. I laid the railroad line 3 miles south, built the highway and we lost the town. Spent a lifetime trying to turn this thing around. Said my family came from nothing. Oh, my daddy, he loved this land. Mama's hand worn and weathered, but together they would stay. This field is mine, I'll be here forever. So draw your big black line, the rocks and the clay and the sands of time. They're here and now, it's one step from forever. Or you can build, burn and borrow, and put up your posted sign. But this field is mine. Well, it's a long, cold, dreamless sleep, they say, but I must disagree. I got the warm summer grass and the earth and leaves, the stars, the
faded memory. Oh, trust me, friend, that the long road's end. Yeah, you're gonna follow me. Though the storm may wear and weather, oh, my spirit is safe and sound. And from now till forever, gonna stand by the sacred ground. This field is mine, always and forever. So draw your big black line. The rocks and the clay and the sands of time, the here and now, is one step from forever. Oh, build and burn and borrow, and put up your posted sign, but this field is mine. And the clay and the sands of time, the here and now, is one step from forever. Oh, you can build and burn and borrow and put up your posted sign, but this field is mine.
This next song I got to write with two amazing friends, and one of the great things about Nashville is you get to make music with your friends. And David Starr, living in Colorado, living in Nashville, and we just made an album together here in town, and it's called Beauty and Ruin, and he's a great artist, singer, songwriter, and of course the legendary Jim Lauderdale, who is needs no introduction, because you all know who he is. Anyway. This is a song that we did on the David Starr album. It's called Road to Jubilee. Now, I've never actually performed this song, but I thought I'd give it a shot, so here we go. But I dreamed about the big house by the side of Laurel Creek. And I'm sitting there in a rocking chair with the children at our feet. When I got a dog called Music and a mule to ride to town. It's all I ever wanted if I ever settle down. Just a boy from Texarkana, found a girl to take him in. Both the love they had and the vows they made always would remain. There's a garden full of thorns. Days of
a brand new song I just wrote about a week ago, and it's about what's going on for all of us. And it's called You Saved My World. Write another song, make another hit. I'm like a well-broken horse trying to spit out the bit. How do you like me now? How do you like me now? Turn off the news, all the doom and gloom. Figure a way to get the world back in tune. I know we will somehow. No, we will somehow. Nowhere to go, dark vision shows. Just one more episode. I hope you try to keep my eyes from closing. Mm-hmm. Said you saved my world. Turn my night to day, turn my dark to light. I said, you saved my world, made everything all right, made everything all right. Looking outside for some kind of life. Pull up the cover, then I'm hoping my dreams will ever make it through. Make it through the night. Do you got enough food? Do you got enough friends? You got enough money when there's nothing to spend at all? Is it coming? Is it gone? Yeah. Nowhere to go. Keep binging the shows. Just one more episode. I know I'm only trying to keep my eyes closing. Oh yeah, I said you saved my world. You make my night to day, turn my dark to light. I said you saved my world. Made everything all right. Made everything. Like to give a big shout out to Music Cares and of course Music City Roots. Music City Roots has been a musical home for me ever since I came to Nashville. So many amazing times there, meeting great people, hearing great performances, and it's just something I'll never forget. And of course I want to give a big shout out to the healthcare workers, the police, firemen, the EMTs, everyone here in Nashville and around the country who are keeping us all safe. And this last song is a song that my mom taught me. She taught me in the kitchen in the early 1950s. Now it goes way back before that, but it's been logged in my musical memory banks ever since. It's called For Me and My Gal. Here we go.
Mm-hmm. do the birds keep singing? Why do the bells keep ringing? I'm gonna give you a big surprise.
Great job from John Oates. It's always a pleasure to have him on Music City Roots. You know, one of the important causes in our musical community right now is Music Cares. Their mission statement is to provide a safety net of critical assistance to music people in times of need. Music Care Foundation is a nonprofit organization established in 1989 and was incorporated in 1993 by the National Academy of Recording Arts and Sciences. Now, as you can imagine, they've been swamped with requests for help, which is focused in these early stages on rent and mortgage assistance. They've already helped hundreds of our musical friends right here in the Nashville and Middle Tennessee area, and many more beyond. Please visit the website on your screen and share something with the music community that brings us so much. Okay, on with the show. Craig Haverhurst is in the chat room. He's moving all over town. And right now, a catch-up visit with our next performer, Lily May.
Lily May, welcome to Music City Roots.
Thanks, Craig. It's so nice to talk with you today. Thank you.
It's nice to talk to anybody.
That's the truth.
I mean, so we were talking and you said that actually not being out among people and not having the relentless sets, because you still play on Lower Broadway and you're traveling a lot, that this has been for you a welcome, unplanned, but welcome break in a way. What's been good about this time?
Definitely. I mean, you know, it's hard to sound too positive because there's so much devastation and so much tragedy and amazing people that are being lost right now. So I don't mean to sound like I'm having too good of a time.
I understand.
Because there's some real negative, you know, outcomes for a lot of people. And that's just awful. It's just so sad. It's too sad. And you know, losing John Prine and other artists. I know, you know, I've a lot of friends that are, that have lost friends, you know, and a lot of people in the music industry. So, anyway, I didn't, not to sound like I'm having too grand jolly of a time over here, but, I was saying before that I feel like my family is in a really great position. We're very lucky. We're blessed. I'm number one. I'm super blessed to have like a big backyard. I'm like, we're gardening a lot, and that's awesome. And that's a blessing. And also, I was supposed to be on tour March, April, and some of May, and so on, but I wasn't going to get to garden this year. So there's that. And I'm grateful for that because I really just so desperately wanted one this year. I'm grateful for that. And I was also saying that, yeah, like a time like this is unasked for, like vocal rest. I'm like, we performing all the time, musicians or singers or whatever, constantly just singing and singing, singing and singing. And I know that you could do your routines and help yourself along, but there's nothing. This is honestly, I think this is the longest, what, a month and a half now, and we've done some shows, but I've been able to rest my vocal cords and be on a most part vocal rest, except for when I have to scream at the dogs when they're running down the street. Like this morning, I let one of them out, or I let them both out, and one of them, just the second I opened the door, it's like 8, maybe 7:30, 8. I open the door and he just takes off after something down the road. So I'm like, oh God, but I gotta get a whistle. Anyway, but it has been, there have been some, we've definitely been making the best out of the time that we have here at home. And also just going through stuff, going through bins and boxes of old papers and started songs and everything that I have personally been putting off for years and years and years. And just, you know, you move here and you move there, I've moved so much in the last few years that I've just, stuff just piled up. So I've had a chance to go through everything. And now I have two medium sized bins and one half a bag to go through. And I'm like, that's everything. I've gone through everything else. So it's pretty good. So there have been some positivities.
I think that's what my mom must be doing, because she this week sent me a bundle of baby pictures. I'm like, I haven't seen those ever.
Yeah, right.
So
I've seen a lot of people doing that too. Yeah. I've seen a lot of baby pictures posted online.
And everybody's posting their high school graduation portraits. It's a thing. You have put out now two wonderful albums in the space of about 4 years, really well received, really innovative and unusual. And it's helped us sort of connect the dots from your family band and Broadway and Gypsy to you now as, you know, a mature recording artist. And you must feel like you've got a more of a sense of what's ahead for you and what you'd like to do and how you'd like to record and what might be next than you might have, say, 4 years ago, right? And I'd love to know, catch us up on where your aspirations are and where you are in the cycle and where you might go back to the studio or change the nature of your show or just
absolutely
anything that's on your mind.
All of that, Craig. And as far as like changing the nature of your show, that's also another time that I feel like, okay, in this time, when we go out again next time, when tour strikes up again, like I'm going to have my together, you know, a lot more so than I can be real last minute and scrambled and always do it or get there. But I've been, you know, writing loads and, no, that, but changing the show, getting little things together, tweaking, like that's definitely happening right now. And also, I can't wait to record again. I'm ready. I'm ready to record the next album or start anyway. It's also hard to, when do you make a new album? When do you release it? You know, I think you do whatever you're compelled to do, or whatever you're allowed to do or able to do financially, or whether, you know, if, you know, it's like just depending on what your situation is with the people you work with and et cetera. But if I could put out a record in the next little bit, I would, but I think, you know, I'll take that slow for sure. But I'm definitely working on it. Definitely writing a bunch, and I've got a lot of ideas towards it. And I have for, you know, even when recording the last album, I could have kept going and going. So it's wow. Hard. It's hard. I won't, you know, I'll, also another thing, like, I guess I used to maybe like, I'd, you know, perform, oh, if I wrote a song, I'd play it for somebody, or I haven't done that stuff in years. You know, I'm like, whatever, maybe one in a blue moon, I'll send something, not very regularly. So like, I'll just have like all this stuff that's like, okay, cool. For me, I'm like, it's just stockpiling in my, you know, anyway, but, and also thank you. Thanks so much. I really, making those records, I was really blessed. I had a wonderful opportunity to get to make those, and I'll always be grateful. So
good. Should always be proud of them. Well, thanks a lot.
Thank you.
And we'll see what you've got planned for us here on the solo show. Are you together with any of your siblings, or just lone Lily Mae?
No, we'll be together. Yep. We've all been quarantined together. So we'll have we won't go crazy. We'll have a full band, but I won't be like, I'm sure we won't go electric. We'll stay. we won't get too crazy, but, yeah, thank you guys so much for the opportunity to play in this time, you know, like super, you know, we can't be downtown. So like, this was like, yes, super, super stoked. We've been doing the live shows, but the Layla's Live from Layla's, but, we're looking forward to playing.
Well, good. The today. Pleasure and honor is all ours. Thanks a lot, and good luck to you and yours.
Thank you, Craig. Thank you so much, and thanks for meeting with me. Appreciate it.
You bet.
Well, folks, not many recording artists can say they grew up in Nashville honky-tonks, but that's very much true for our next guest. Playing with her family band, she was on stage on Lower Broadway throughout the 2000s. Now she's a widely known fiddler, singer, and songwriter with two highly acclaimed albums. And I've had the pleasure of singing with her on many occasions. Please welcome Lily Mae.
Hello. Hello. We're so glad to be here at Music City Roots. Thank you for having us. Here's a tune called How. Am I here, hounds. Just kidding. All right, here's one called Blue Heart. Whole Blue Heart. This one's written after the Blue Heart emoji. Am I right? No. Are we doing what's the second one?
Crisp and Cold.
All right, never mind. We'll get to that one in a second. This one's Crisp and Cold. What's that? In your eyes, rendezvous is red. In a bind, wonder can be found. Green says go, the moon dies, the sun is on the rise. Orange and bright, and Blue Heart. Thank you. Brother Frank's going to sing this next one for us. Thank you.
Well, everybody's gone away. Said they moved up to L.A. There's not a friend I know around, 'cause everybody's leaving town. Some caught a freight, some caught a plane to find the sunshine, lose the rain. You know this town will waste your time. I guess they're right, it's wasting mine. And some got a some got a win, and some got a win. time Charles got the blues.
Well, Brother Frank Carter on the guitar and singing over here. Sister Scarlett on the mandolin.
Hi.
And Sparkles, Sparkle Bear. On the drums is Misa Arriaga.
Yeah.
And Darren Terrio on the bass. And I'm Lily May. And thank you all so much for having us, and thanks for listening. Our last number, we'll take her on home with one called Didn't I? All right. Thank you. Thanks, Music City Roots.
Jinx.
Thanks, everyone, for listening.
Oh, another great performance from Lily May. So good to have you on the show. You're listening to WMOT Roots Radio, Murfreesboro, Nashville, 89.5 on your FM dial. We're proud to have them as a radio partner, and we want to remind you that WMOT is a nonprofit, publicly funded radio station. And here's Craig with Executive Director Val Heppner.
Joining me now on from our respective homes, not too far apart, Executive Director of WMOT Roots Radio, Val Heppner. Hi, Val.
Hey, Craig, it's good to see you, see your face. I've missed seeing your face in the office.
Me too, miss being there. It's been about 5 or plus weeks now, which is crazy to imagine, but we've got HQ right over my shoulder and been trying to cover the waterfront and file stuff and keep the conversation going with our viewers and listeners and readers. And the feeling of community is strong, even at a distance. And I know you felt that this past week when Public Radio Day came around and you and Jesse spent a good deal of time on the air sort of shuttling among a bunch of wonderful sets from the past. So what was the philosophy of the day?
Well, you know, we had intended to have this great live in-person concert all day long to celebrate Public Radio Music Day. It's the first one, and it really is an opportunity for us to talk to people that maybe don't understand what public radio is, or, you know, maybe spread the word about public radio. And so, you know, Jesse and I decided that maybe what we ought to do is go back through our archives and pull out some of the best concerts that we had over the last 12 months. And replay them on the air as if it was a radio festival. And so we did 15 hours, and we started off with Tanya Tucker from our Americana Fest day stage that we partnered with NPR Music and World Cafe on, and ended with the Mavericks from that same stage. And, you know, it's really interesting. People really responded to that because I think they're craving live music. I think, you know, just like, you know, Music City Roots is trying right now to, you know, sort of get the community together. It was really a bonding moment. It was really fun to post all of that on social media and have people reach out to me and say, oh my God, I was there at that show. It was so great. Or, oh, I missed this. Thank you for bringing us that. It gave us an opportunity to, you know, talk about what we do really well at WMOT, and that's bring you, you know, music discovery and allow you to experience the music close up. And, you know, beyond that, our next pillar of, you know, service is really just building a community. And I think we, you know, accomplished that on Public Radio Music Day.
Well, it's so great because those sessions that you all put together are super special, but they're sort of one-time only events. And so to review them, they're really worthy of replay and as good as the original time. So an inspired solution to a problem, which is kind of what everybody's doing. And I've noticed that my orientation, and I'm, you know, those of us who have who continue to have jobs, we our hearts break for those who've not been able to go on the road, not seen their income vanish for at least the time being. But those who haven't, I've suddenly said to myself, how can I help artists directly? Look at you know, Caleb Caudle. Let's buy that LP. I bought off Wild Ponies this past week, and John Bird, and looking around for ways that I can, you know, sort of, I'm saving money on eating out. So it's going, and fortunately my membership to MOT is on autopilot, so I don't have to think about that one. But in terms of re-upping the commitment to the cultural contributors to Nashville and Middle Tennessee and to the nation, it's time to do that. And how can folks who want to make WMOT part of that pantheon of support do so most effectively right now?
You know, most effectively, it's just to become a member of WMOT. If you have, you know, been a listener for a long time, you've listened to Music City Roots on WMOT and all of our other programming, you know, The String from Craig, really just going to WMOT.org and clicking on that donate button and finding a way that fits with your budget to support us. As a member, we want to grow our community, and the only way to do that is to grow our membership. Every dollar of that goes to our broadcast operations. We're a pretty tight organization, as Craig knows, and you know, membership really means a lot to us. There are other ways that people can support us, you know, in bigger ways. There's program partner opportunities and things like that. But really, we just want to broaden our community, because what we're able to do is, you know, jump in with young artists. You mentioned, you know, Caleb Cottle, and help NPR Music discover him first and foremost, but secondly, bring you know, his live session to NPR Music and to the livesessions.npr.org you know, audience. And that's what we feel like we can do in the artist community right now. But we're also doing that, you know, for our listeners and our, you know, loyal members too.
Yeah. Yeah. Donations to public radio have multiplier effects if you love the music and you love the artists. So great. Val, thanks a lot. We will be, you know, we're on with the show, and we're going to keep pushing the great art made by Nashville's artists and the national Americana scene in every way we can. So thanks for your support, and we'll hope to round up some for y'all.
Thanks so much, Craig.
Thanks to Val Heppner and all the team for keeping the music flowing over WMOT-FM and WMOT.org. They're more than worthy of our support, because you are the public in public radio. Okay, our next set comes from a bluegrass star with so much to say as a musician. Here's Craig with a brief chat with Sierra Hull and Justin Moses.
Sierra Hull and Justin Moses, hey.
Hey!
Hey, hey.
Most unusual Music City Roots interview I've ever done, but we roll with the times.
I mean, yeah, I appreciate you guys still trying to bring some entertainment to the good people of the world.
Yeah, absolutely. Give me a little sense of what that experience has been like for you, the shows online, the variety of things you've done, and just how it feels, if you are able to feel any feedback and from the folks on the other end.
Yeah, I've done a fair amount of live streams in the last few weeks, and we did one together last week, was it, sometime or so? And yeah, it's been really nice to feel somewhat connected in a way, because for us, this is such a new feeling of just being home and not performing. I mean, I haven't been home this much since, you know, I lived with my mom and dad years ago. So it's really crazy to sort of, you know, have all of the live performances be shut down like this. And so I'm grateful for technology that allows us to be able to still connect with fans and play music.
I'm sure you're hearing from them. The extra pity is that you have a wonderful new album that you are going to be playing out on. But I have been enjoying it. It's called 25 Trips. And I have not heard you tell the story about why this record came along at just this time.
Yeah, it's sort of was a bummer to have the whole, you know, whole tour be canceled right as the record had just came out. But, you know, many people are kind of in a similar boat of seeing everything kind of be shut down for now. So hard to complain. But yeah, the record is kind of a long time in the works. And of course, you know, we decided to call it 25 Trips because there's a song on the record, 25 Trips Around the Sun. And it's like basically, there's a lot of themes of time, which, funny enough, now that all this is happening, feels more relevant to me than it even did when I released the record. But sort of the push and pull of time, and I know personally my concept more than ever of time feels really skewed right now. Just being able to, you know what day it is, let alone, you know how I feel, you know, from hour to hour with all this kind of crazy stuff happening. So, the record basically really dives into that concept, and 25 trips, just the idea of that theme, and 25 being kind of a very important year in my life, from us getting married to certain things in my career. Even though, you know, there's some other themes on the record as well, that just really felt like a song that sort of tied it all together. And working with Shawnee Gondi as my co-producer and engineer on the record, that track really felt sort of like one of
the more experimental tracks in terms of using the studio and us collaborating on, you know, a particular sound of the record that sort of reflected a particular side of us, I guess. So that's the short story.
Well, sound is what
short,
it's all
long
about.
Story.
There's so many more musicians than your last project, which was very spare, and you've pulled in sort of a lot more of your the bluegrass elements, but there's also some feeling of orchestral and wide open sound. That's what's it's been so great. I love the track "How Long," which, you know, kind of blasts into a Newgrass kind of thing with, I think, Stuart Duncan playing a big fiddle.
He is. Oh yeah.
Solo on
good
there.
Good old Stu Bob. Yep. He a played so great on that.
So talk about the cast of musicians and the kind of the aural idea that the record wanted to be.
Yeah, well, there's sort of three different ways that we went about recording this record. One of them being, you know, using the studio, kind of like I meant mentioned the track 25 Trips, being one that Shawnee and I kind of worked together to sort of play around with elements in the studio, of me layering my own vocals. And a lot of things started with just mandolin and voice, and we kind of expanded around that. But then there's also tracks that have more of a live band setting, with having some of my bluegrass heroes like Stuart Duncan and Brian Sutton and Justin here and Vic Krause. We recorded a handful of tracks that way too, which inherently feels different than when you build a track from the ground up, you know, in the studio. And then there's a couple tracks that are more stripped down singer-songwriter with just guitar and vocal, and are kind of presented very much in the way they would have been written, you know, just me and a guitar. So I think that approach kind of allowed me to both push ahead with trying some new things on this record, but also tap back into the stripped down nature of my Weighted Mind record, but then even go back and invite back in some of my favorite bluegrass players like Stuart and Brian that had been on some of my previous albums as well. So it's kind of a variety of things that sort of put new and old together for me on this record.
Sweet. Justin, what's your take on this record? You've heard Sierra's other work. I don't know if you've participated in any albums with her before, but what's your version of this story of this record?
No, I hadn't participated in any of the other ones. No, I've been I was a fan from the beginning of the songs she had, and just it was very interesting watching the songs that I had heard in their, you know, demo form or whatever, that she had just, you know, written the songs, come together. And I've loved every minute of watching it come together.
Fantastic. What are we hearing from you guys on this set?
Well, Justin, speaking of records, has been working on a new record, so we're going to play a song from that record. It's going to be an awesome project. It's kind of the fun thing about us living under the same roof and both being musicians, is I've just got through working on that record for so long, and he was alongside me through the whole process, and hearing, you know, all the mixes and hearing the songs from the early conception to the, you know, going into the studio and then coming to life with other musicians. I'm in the process of getting to experience the joy of watching him make a record and hearing all these songs come from just ideas to actual things. So we're going to play a song off that.
Yeah. We'll
do one off my 25 Trips record. We're going to go back and possibly play something from my very first record, Secrets, and then maybe even a cover or two. So yeah.
Sounds great. We're looking forward to it, and we'll see how it all comes together.
It's gonna be fun. I'm so excited you guys
continued are continued good luck to
thrilled
y'all
that we're able to be a part.
Oh, it means the world
thank
to
you.
Us. And we'll be watching for you there and on other online destinations until we're back out in a field somewhere, right?
That's right.
Okay.
We look forward to it.
See you guys.
It was clear early on that this musician was special. She was just a kid when she was signed by Rounder Records, releasing her debut album at 16. And now she's one of our most admired all-around acoustic musicians. Her new album is called 25 Trips, and it's a trip to know her. And her masterful musical husband is picking alongside her. Folks, please welcome from home, Here are Sierra Hall and Justin Moses.
Part of this lineup for you this afternoon, and thanks for tuning in and helping raise some money for Music Cares. We've been a part of Music City Roots many times over the years, and excited to get to be part of it this time, coming to you from my office here in Nashville, Tennessee, in our house. We're going to play some original music for you, as well as a few covers. We're going to turn it over to Justin here, and we're going to play, turn it over to you. You like
it? Yeah,
it's just the two of us, but we're going to turn it over to this one, and I'm going to help him as we turn it over to him.
Do one of my tunes called Streets of Savannah. Thank you.
Streets of Savannah. That's off of an EP called Beyond Measure that he released a few years back, and been working on a new album as well. We'll play you one of those before the evening's over off of that. But first, we want to go back and play one by one of our favorite bluegrass singers. Of course, we both grew up being big Larry Sparks fans, so we're going to do you one off of an album he did called Travelin' way back when, probably around the time I was born. One, sung slow, played fast. It's called Taking a Slow Train. Taking a Slow Train. Recent album.
It's
now
due.
It's due. What do you say? So actually hanging out here in the background, 25 Trips, like I said, we're in my office, fits with the color scheme. We're gonna do one off of my most recent album. It came out February 28th of this year, so just not too long ago. This is the very first track off that record, which I wrote right here in this room. It's called Beautifully Out of Place.
You believe in me, I can't see what you see. How long is it gonna take me to trust myself? I've been stuck here so long, gotta find a way to move on. I gotta get on out of here, I gotta let go of this fear. Oh, I swore I'd never let it go. Now another year, I'm stuck here in the dark. Maybe
Episode of Music City Roots, and big thank you to all the wonderful folks over there for giving us a chance to be part of this incredible lineup alongside some of our friends and heroes. We're going to do one more song for you and say goodnight, and hopefully we'll see you guys somewhere out there in person before too long. We've missed seeing everybody and missed playing music, but so glad we get the chance to be able to connect this way. So thanks for tuning in. We'll leave you with a one off Justin's upcoming record, which is going to be an awesome record. I've been listening to it a lot lately. He's getting close to being done.
This tune's called Texland.
the always delightful Sierra Hull, the belle of Byrdstown, Tennessee, and her husband, Justin Moses. That's great work. Support for this broadcast comes from All Aboard Madison, building a brand new home for Music City Roots to open in 2021 when we debut Music City Roots live from Madison Station. Now, for those of you watching on video, just want to show you these renderings of our beautiful barn, starting construction later this spring, right next to Johnny Cash's beloved Amqui train station. Special thanks to the Kennedy family and also to Madison and Metro Nashville for welcoming us to this new Madison Station Boulevard neighborhood. Keeping track of the progress on Music City Roots, social media, and website. Now let's check in with Craig and Jim in the chat room.
Jim, we had to just have a quick chat to see what's up in your world. I know you're not touring, but you've got a new record out, and there's another fun song that I've heard that I heard you on that I want to ask about. But just tell us quickly, like, how you've been doing and how you've been making use of the time. But first, has Jim Lauderdale ever had a beard before?
No, he hasn't.
About that,
Jim Lauderdale has never had a beard, and it was I shaved this part off the other day, but decided to keep this for a little while.
Good.
You know, but Craig,
I'm
doing okay. I hope you pardon.
It's a time for new things, but yes, doing fine. But what's been going on in your world basically?
You know, I've been exercising a lot, learning some new Tai Chi things. The music, I've been resting my voice and my fingers, but getting back into things, started a few songs, learning some old ones, and as you mentioned, I've got the new bluegrass thing, and so I'm, you know, looking forward to doing some stuff with that when it's time, and thinking about future projects and things, and just, you know, trying to be healthy and sending a lot of good thoughts and love out to everybody out there in the world.
Fair enough. Yeah, the project is When Carolina Comes Home Again. How many bluegrass albums into your career is this? Is this about number four, five?
To get to the other side. No, I'm kidding. Like, that was a punchline to how many chickens cross the road. This is my 10th bluegrass album. It's my 33rd album.
Oh my gosh, I really hadn't caught it counted in a while.
Yeah. You know, time flies.
And what sparked this? You had a bunch of songs about North Carolina, or there was some sort of commission. This was instigated by what?
Well, I was talking to my friend Cy Kahn, who we wrote that song Kakalaki together, and Cy and I had been talking for several years about doing something together, and he brought up to me that this was the year of music in North Carolina. So I thought, maybe a bluegrass album recorded in North Carolina using North Carolina musicians would be a great kind of theme for the, I mean, you know, kind of a concept. And John Oates and I had written a song a few years back called When Carolina Comes Home Again. And of course, John's roots are in folk music. He loved Doc Watson. And so when it was time to go in to the studio, I went into Echo Mountain there in Asheville, North Carolina, and got a bunch of great players for this first three tracks, including my banjo player my banjo teacher when I was 15, and I was in Flat Rock, North Carolina that summer, and got Mark Pruitt, who's with Balsam Range, to be on that session, because that really kind of was bringing the circle around. But I thought, you know, this title and the opening track, the song John Oates and I wrote, When Carolina Comes Home Again, really worked perfectly for that. So the rest of the album, then I thought, okay, the second song, I'll do Kakalaki. that Cycon and I wrote. Kakalaki, folks, is kind of a nickname for Carolinas. And and then I just went from there. Got folks, I mentioned Balsam Range, had them, Steep Canyon Rangers, Cane Mill Road, Songs of the Road Band, Town Mountain, Presley Barker, John
Steele. So it became a showcase for the talent of the region besides just a thematic song book.
Yes, that's right. And to be honest with you, I ran out of time before I could finish. There were other Carolina artists and bands I wanted to include. So I might have to do a part two. I'm always thinking about doing a double album, and this has 13 tracks. But so there are plenty of artists out there to get on the next one, and plenty of writers I haven't written with, including some of the folks I already wrote with for this record.
Well, you're preaching to the choir with me. I mean, I've been so proud from the state and to watch the music scene grow and develop from the time I was in high school, really. But it's only in these last 10 years, the western part of the state has become an absolute anchor. Echo Mountain is one of the reasons that people have sort of gone there to record and in some cases just stay there. Like the quality of life is so good. And there's so many breweries with venues, and the people who live there, it's not a big population, but they go see music, and great fans, great talent. So another one before we wrap to ask you about is just a track I love. You made a record with Western Centuries called Space Force.
Oh, yeah.
And it's just fun as can be. And I love the whole album. It's great. I've enjoyed that band, but never more than this record. But what's the story there?
My friend Jim Miller in Western Centuries said, hey, we're in town recording. Would you sing some harmonies on some things? So I went over there and sang on a couple of things, and one of them was Space Force. So they were plowing right along into getting things done. And did that cut off for a minute?
I did lose the video. Yes.
Went blank. Okay.
Why don't you start your answer again with your friend.
Okay. I got a call from my friend Jim Miller, who's in Western Centuries, and said they had a few songs, was wondering if I would sing some harmonies on. So I went over there and to the studio and Space Force was one of them.
They had written that song.
Yeah.
You picked up.
Yeah.
Okay, great.
And I'm a big fan of Western Centuries, and I hope we can do a lot of stuff together, more gigs and more recording.
Well, we are going to get to hear a set by you from your lockdown, and we'll roll right into that, but it's great to be part of a show with you again, Jim. It's great to see you.
Yes,
great to see you looking so healthy, and the beard looks sporting. I think I like it. I shaved mine off.
I like you shaved. It looks good.
The weather came, got too nice. It was gone. But hey, rock on and stay safe.
You too, Craig. Thank you.
All right.
Well, this is a familiar job in an unfamiliar situation, but it always gives me great pleasure to introduce our musical host for a set of music. He's a songwriter, a global performer, a master of country and bluegrass, and he's got that new album you just heard about, When Carolina Comes Home Again. One more time, give it up for our own Jim Lauderdale.
Summer is over. Frost in the field. Something unbroken. Something so real. I wanna live in the love we have. had then. When Carolina comes home again. Time always teaches, the seasons renew, the mountains and beaches I walked with you. Our road is a story without any end. Tell Carolina comes home again. When Carolina comes home again, I can still feel you laying so close. I look for a lifeline after you go. That's what I hold on to as hard as I can until Carolina comes home again. When Carolina comes home again, it's all in the letters, the love that we made, the thoughts that we wrote with will never fade. What's left behind us is the love we had then. Oh, Carolina, come home again. When Carolina comes home again, when Carolina comes home again.
Hey, everybody, thanks so much again for tuning in tonight to Music City Roots and inviting us into your homes. And we sure have missed you. And I sure have missed the Music City Roots family. And so this is a very special evening for all of us. Hey, that song was the title track of a brand new bluegrass album I've got out. I recorded it in North Carolina at Echo Mountain Studios. And I wrote that with my friend John Oates, When Carolina Comes Home Again. And on this album, I've got a bunch of great guest artists playing with me and singing and picking. Balsam Range, John Stickley with Lindsey Pruitt, Presley Barker, Cane Mill Road, Town Mountain, songs from the Road Band, and on this song, the Steep Canyon Rangers. And this is a tune I wrote with my friend Logan Ledger, who's got a great new record out. So be looking for that. And we wrote this kind of in the gospel style of Flat and Scruggs, the way they used to do stuff. And it's called Better Than You Found It. Nobody thinks that it's gonna happen. They always put it off another day. Whatever's gonna happen ever after, don't you know it's surely on the way. While you're getting ready to leave this earthly plane, have you
made your peace, or will you walk around it? Are you leaving this world better than you found it? Before you think you hear the angels knocking and understand it's your time to go, what can we leave behind to help tomorrow? When you're gone, how will your garden grow? While you're getting ready to leave this earthly plane, have you made your peace, or will you walk around it? Are you leaving this world better than you found it? While you're getting ready to leave this earthly plane, have you made your peace, or will you walk around it? Are you leaving this world better than you found it? Are you leaving this world better than you found it?
All right. Hey, speaking of bluegrass, be looking out for a single from a young fella that I just produced an album for him in North Carolina. And his name is Alex Leach. Super talented. He's from the Knoxville area. And Alex, if you've seen Ralph Stanley II anytime in the last 7 years, Alex was playing banjo for him. And now he's stepping out and playing a lot of lead guitar. Great writer and singer. Be looking out for him, Alex Leach. Well, folks, I'm not a doctor. I just play one on Music City Roots. And I'm stitching together and patching together a show for you, my portion of the show. And this is a song from a record I put out last June, and it's called From Another World. And this is a song that I wrote with the great Buddy Cannon, and my manager, Jeremy Dillon, did a video of this song down in Australia a year ago last March. And I'm doing a Tai Chi style that I just learned from my teachers, Master Rose Oliver and Master Wong Ming Bo. And it's from the Yang family style. So check out that video for this song called Listen. I know, 'cause one time I was just like you. If the words come out before you think, then you know not of what you speak, and you come off sounding like a fool. If you believe you're always right, you're wrong, and that's an oversight. Nobody's right that much of the time. If you got all the answers, who's asking all the questions? No one can get a word in edgewise. Listen, listen, listen. Try not to talk for a while. Listen, listen, listen. Even though
that's really not your style. To myself, maybe insecurity does you like it did to me. Afraid you're not good enough inside. Listen, listen, listen. Try not to talk. For a while. Listen, listen, listen. Even though that's really not your style, you think you know everything, but you don't know lots of things. I know, 'cause one time I was just like you. Let's keep that between ourselves. Some things you don't have to tell till later on, 'cause here comes you know who. You think you know everything, but you don't know lots of things.
I sure enjoyed working on that record, From Another World, and I got to co-produce both of the Time Flies, the record out a year before that, and this From Another World record with the great Jay Weaver. They played bass on it and co-produced it. And here's a song, and by the way, folks, you know, gosh, I wish that I wasn't such a Luddite, you know, meaning I'm just not very technical. This is just kind of old school, the way I'm doing this. You know, I kind of like to think it would be like if Ralph Peer or Alan Lomax came in here, you know, back in the 20s and 30s and as if this was a field recording. Just think of it like that, okay? It kind of adds something to it. You know, it seems like a lost recording. It's squeaking old chair, you know, all of that stuff. So anyway, just keep that in mind as you listen. I was mentioning my manager, Jeremy Dillon, and he recommended that we do a single now of this song I'm about to do, and it's going to be out really soon, a studio version of it that I recorded a few years ago, and I've never put it on an album, and but it seemed like a timely thing, and I wrote it with Eddie Perez and Lance Miller. And the single is produced by Jimmy Ritchie. And this one's called I've Still Got You. The world's gone crazy, it seems, here lately. People are losing everything. One thing's for certain,
might be two, but I've still got you. Can't seem to win. There you are, back again. At least one thing is true, I've still got you. I'm optimistic, but up ahead, and if you're a memory that I'll keep with me, that'll get me through, 'cause I've still got you. Here come the storms, and then when I just can't seem to win, there you are, here again. At least one thing is true, I've still got you, thick and thin. When I just can't seem to win, there you are, back again. Thing is true, I've still got you. The world's gone crazy.
Thanks, everybody. You guys take good care, okay? Oh, I've got time for one more? Okay. Well, I'll tell you what. I'll do a song that I wrote with a very talented young songwriter named Sarah Duguay. And this one is off of the record From Another World. Folks, thanks again. Look forward when we can all see each other in person. And like I say, in the meantime, you take really good care.
I'll forgive you if you don't. I'll still be there if you won't. Wanna tell me that you feel the same way too? You could go on all night long, and on and on. Tell me anything you want, I'll forgive you if you don't. If you feel like jumping in, I'm ready, let's begin. We could give this thing a try if you want, because every now and then a woman and a man might think their heart's at home. I'll forgive you if you don't. want to leave the friend zone and keep everything just the way it is. Are we on the same page? Have we gotten to that stage? Do you feel the haw, haw, haw? I'll forgive you if you don't. If you feel like jumping in, I'm ready, let's begin. We could give this thing a try if you want. Because every now and then, a woman and a man might think their heart's at home. I'll forgive you if you don't. Do you feel the haw, haw, haw? I'll forgive you if you don't. I'll forgive you if you don't.
Thanks, everybody. We'll see you next time here at Music City Roots.
What would Music City Roots would be without the great Jim Lauderdale? And I mean that from the bottom of my heart, Jim. I know you don't think I do, but I really do. You're listening to Roots Radio, WMOT, Murfreesboro, Nashville, playing friends, legends, and heroes like Jim Lauderdale, just like we are here tonight. Don't forget, tonight's show is all about helping our partners at WMOT, so please visit WMOT.org and click that donate button. Very important. Also visit Music Cares online. Please, everyone, every artist, and the MCR production crew have all donated their time to help our music community. Large or small, every donation makes a huge difference, and we really appreciate it. We also want to thank Subaru for their generous continued support of WMOT during these crazy times. Please visit them at Subaru.com. And now here's Craig to chat with our final artist.
Hey, Sam Bush, welcome to the virtual Music City Roots chat room.
We're virtual. Hello, Craig. Welcome, everybody.
It's wonderful to see your face. How are you and Lynn making out over there in your comfortable adobe?
Doing great. You know, we find in this day and age of spring training, there's a baseball spring training, I should say, for all you folks out there. There's a replay of an old game every day now. So, doing well.
Watching the MLB Network, and you're watching old baseball games. I think I'm going to sign up because I'm feeling the loss.
I know. Well, but you know, it's fun to watch the old games. But feeling very incredibly fortunate to be at home and not, you know, maybe that we weren't stranded out on the road somewhere when we all needed to start hunkering down in place. So fortunate to be at home and riding it out. So feeling fortunate.
I spoke with Stephen Mogin, your guitar player and singer from your band, just about two to three weeks ago. He described you all being happily on the road, rolling along, doing dates, and you did have to come. You did get sort of realized that it was time to come home, and dates were canceled and so forth. But you were touring this winter, right?
Yes, we were. We had just gone on our trip where we did 12 shows in 14 days. So it was rolling. And we started in St. Louis, then went on to Hutchinson, Kansas, you know, where of course the Kansas State Fair occurs. And then on to Colorado, mountain communities, Denver, Boulder, and then up Steamboat through, you know, Utah. It was just great. It was just such a fun trip we had. A new banjo player in the band, Wes Corbett, was first tour, and everything's really going well. And then, you know, we had found that we were our last show was in Fort Collins, Colorado, so we did the old what you call deadheaded home and the bus. But by the, for our own safety, we, you know, you stop to let the driver sleep. And so right before we pulled out, Wes's wife called and said, "There's no toilet paper in Nashville." So Wes was at a store and picked us all up. big packs. So we came home actually stocked, but it was in that department. And then we got home, and everyone's businesses all started, and everyone's lives started changing. Like almost, we got home March 12th. And yeah, it was,
that was
like,
the weekend.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that weekend things started changing.
The day
around the country.
The live music. Anyway, do you play much at home now to just kind of let it flow? You told me you got a guitar that you've been enjoying.
Yes. I have a new old guitar that my good friend Clayton passed along to me. And my first D28. So that's fun playing that. It is so different, you know. Those of us that play the steel stringed instruments, you get your callus space going, and coming home off that trip I was just telling you about, we were all tough and ready. We were all really warmed up, mm-hmm. having a great time with it. But it's just different calluses. So I look forward to sitting in a circle and picking.
Well, I tell you, I had a thought. Where am I going with this? You've been doing a series online in honor of your hero, Jethro Byrne, Homer and Jethro series. Can you tell folks about that and where we can find it?
Well,
why? What motivated that?
Lynn and I were talking and just realized what would help get us through this pandemic. Why, Homer and Jethro, of course. And, and for those of you that don't know who they are, there, you'll just look them up. Hank Williams that said you weren't a success till Homer and Jethro butchered one of your songs.
Because they did parodies back in the day.
They were the
Weird Al Yankovic of their time. Yeah.
Right. Thank you for explaining what I was trying to explain.
They're all good.
And a little known to, you know, the mass audience, to just be watching them on TV. And they were TV stars in the 50s and 60s. And little did people know that both of them were masterful musicians. Homer Haynes on guitar was just so knowledgeable and masterful, beautiful tone jazz musicians. And Jethro on mandolin was the king of the jazz mandolin for me. And so I would always marvel at the mandolin playing, and I didn't really pay a lot of attention to their songs. They just happened to make two instrumental albums that I was fortunate to find out about, and so I just marveled at their instrumental playing. And only in the last few years I started listening to the comedy songs, really. But we knew Jethro because we never got to meet Homer, and Jethro used to open shows for the Newgrass Revival we met in the early 70s. And so, you know, I got to be around him a lot. And he wasn't my teacher, but He led by example, let's put it that way. He taught me, if you're going to make fun of anybody, you got to make fun of everybody. Yeah. That was his theory.
So you're just doing little stories and knocking out a tune kind of
thing? What we are doing is Homer Jethro's Corner, where nothing is politically correct. Yeah. Why? Because they're Homer Jethro songs from the 50s and 60s. Although their subject matter, you know, was always clean. It was always on the radio. But
They slipped a few references past the censors, I think.
Sure. Yeah. And of course, Chet Atkins was producing these records and playing on them. So that there's, you know, all of a sudden there'll be these great guitar solos, and some of the great guitar solos were Jethro's too. So it's just fun, you know, so I just maybe introducing people to Homer and Jethro's lyrics that haven't heard them before, but just trying to have a little fun every Friday.
Perfect. So before we go, what are you going to be playing for us today on the show?
Well, just trying to have basically tunes that people have told us over the years that are positive for them. Yeah. And you and I talked about this the other day, that how more than ever understanding how songs can make people feel, and maybe if there's a little bit of uplifting in a song, then great. then that's, you know, that we all can relate to that. I know I do. So at any rate, just and ones that people have maybe asked for a little bit here and there. So it's just by myself, of course, but there's an instrumental I play on the slide mandolin called Watson Almond, Girl of the North Country by Bob Dylan, people. A little solo version of Howling at the Moon, where, you know, we hear people, some people howl at the moon at 8 p.m. when they open their door and howl. So we got a song for you if you want to howl along with this one. Everything is Possible, that Deborah Holland and I wrote years ago. Deborah, if any of you ever listened to an incredible pop band called Animal Logic, which was a trio of Stuart Copeland on drums, Stanley Clark on bass, and Deborah on keyboards and vocals, and she wrote all the songs, did all the singing on the records, and so Deborah's tremendous songwriter, and so we wrote this one years ago, Everything is Possible. And then another tune called Face Tomorrow that hadn't done that one for a long time, and it's a positive message. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, people wanted to hear, some folks wanted to hear Circles Around Me, so those numbers.
Brilliant. Well, you put me in mind of one of my favorite Sam Bush memory, at least one where we weren't talking in person, but at Telluride one year, I watched the planets, Venus and Mercury, set on one side down the canyon as it got dark. And then just as it was dark, you came on stage, started singing that song, and the moon rose over the mountain right over the stage. And it was as cosmic a musical moment as I've ever had. So we'll have to pray and wait for Telluride to come back, just like everything else, but it will. And we'll see you there. And see you online, man.
See you online. Thanks, Craig.
Thank you, Sam Bush. We love you.
Our next guest played the second ever Music City Roots show in 2009. But hey, there's a lot more backstory than that. He blazed new trails in bluegrass starting around 1970. And he's been one of our most beloved and adventuresome entertainers and artists ever since. He's a Nashville and national treasure. So let's head to the home of Sam Bush.
Speaking of positive energy, you know, not all songs can be positive in subject matter. But this one is. Deborah Holland and I wrote this one. And thinking about this on Earth Day, too, everything is possible. You may try to have a perfect life. This you cannot do. This you cannot do. It may look like others have this life, this perfect state of bliss. But if you scratch the surface, there is something that you miss. Everything is possible. Everything can change. Anything can happen. Nothing stays the same. Everything is possible. You can't deny it's true. So who's to say something wonderful won't happen to you? You may try to have all sunny days. This you cannot do. You got to brave the stormy nights before the rains come shining through. Put away the razor blade, put away the rope. Change the old prescription for a brand new bottle of hope. Everything is possible. Everything can change. Anything can happen.
stay the same. Everything is possible. You can't deny it's true. So who to say something wonderful won't happen to you?
Here's a tune written by a lady from Louisville, Kentucky named Faith Pilla. And just thinking about some positive energy for you. Face Tomorrow. Searching for, don't know what I'll find. Is everything ahead of me? I got nothing left behind, so I'll face tomorrow like yesterday. Face tomorrow, come what may. Not no map for this journey. I'm just gonna feel my way. Got no destination. Got no place to stay. So I'll face tomorrow like yesterday. Face tomorrow. Come what may. Face tomorrow. Yesterday, face tomorrow. Searching is easy. It's the finding that's hard, so hard. Just keep looking and you'll discover who you are. Life's too short to second guess. I'll surely make mistakes. Well, I'll just try and do my best, no matter what it takes. So I'll face tomorrow like yesterday. Face tomorrow. Face tomorrow like yesterday. Face tomorrow. Here's a little tune that made up a number of years ago in honor of two of my favorite slide guitar players, Merle Watson and Dwayne Allman. So my buddy Mark Winchester named this one Watson Allman. Let's make sure I'm turned up to 11 here. There we go. All right. Watson Allman. buddy of mine said one time, boys, you can't go wrong with a Bob Dylan song, and I couldn't agree more. So here's a tune that Lynn and I love a lot, and especially since it's kind of for her, because I'm originally from way down south in southern Kentucky, and she's from way up north, Louisville. So here's her tune. If you're traveling through the North Country Fair, where the winds blow heavy on the borderline, remember me to the one who lives there. She once was a true love of mine. If you're going where the snowflake storms, where the rivers freeze and the summer ends, see for me, she has a coat so warm to keep her from the howling winds. Please see if her hair hangs so long, rose and flows all around her breast. See for me if her hair hangs long. That's the way I remember her best. They say around 8 p.m. at night, every night in America these days, that some people are going out and howling at the moon at that time. So wherever you're at on your time zone, if you feel like doing a little howling at 8 p.m., got a song for you. Somebody said, keep your eyes open, gotta keep your feet. feet on solid ground. You gotta take time to take a real good look at everything you've found. Take your life as it may come, cause boy, it'll be gone soon. Take a little time for howling at the moon. Take a little time for sunshine. Take a whole lot of time for love. Take time to praise and thank heaven up above. Gotta make music. Raise your voice with joy every day. Got a lot to live for. You got a lifetime to stay. So I try to keep my eyes open, try to live my life from day to day. But seeds of life's unhappiness can't believe me astray. Tell us all a friend. Go down hard and made me sing a different tune. Made me take a little time for howling at the moon. Take a little time for sunshine. Take a whole lot of time for love. Take time to praise and thank heaven up above. Take your life as it may come, cause boy, it'll be gone soon. Take a little time for howling at the moon. Take a little time for sunshine. Take a whole lot of time for love. Take time to praise and thank heaven up above. Got to make music. Raise your voice, it'll be gone soon. Take a little time for howling at the moon. Take a little time for sunshine. Take a whole lot of time for love. Take time to praise and thank heaven up above. Here's a song Jeff Black and I wrote a number of years ago, and perhaps you've heard me say it on stage. It's really just a song of thanks, and that I hope we're all thankful for what we do have right now. So here's a tune by Jeff and me. Riding down through the grapevine, when I heard someone say your name. Hand on my shoulder, just a little bit older now, and I remember everything. High in Telluride, up on Bridal Veil, 10,000 feet above the sound. The news came around and sent me to count on my blessings and to thank you for all the good friends that I've found. Hey, 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 how in the world did we get this far? Hey, 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 holding tight to the tail of a shooting star. Hey, 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 you're running circles around me, circles around me now. Was I dreaming? Did this really happen? I can feel the earth below my feet. The world is turning fast and wild. I'm like a little newborn baby child who's never known regret defeat. I am surrounded, tangled in the wire, drawn up tight to the calling and the rising frequency of the silent smiles and laughter of those that came before, and the deafening sound of all this love falling down on me. Hey, 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 how in the hell did we get this far? Hey, holding tied to the tail of a shooting star. Hey, hey, hey. You're running circles around me, circled around me now. Hey, hey, hey. Circled around me, circled around me now. Round me now, circled around me now. You're running circled around me. Round me now.
Sam Bush, always a great job. Well, folks, that's almost it for us this evening. We always end, as you know, with a jam. And while that's not logistically possible right now with the artist playing from home, we found a very special jam from Music City Roots way back in 2018, one that features most of the artists that you saw tonight. Now, as we roll out with an inspiring song for our times from the Youngbloods, we want to send our best wishes to you and the Roots community and to music fans and music people all over the world. Be good to one another. Stay in touch, of course, at a scientifically approved distance, and share and support the work of your favorite artist being made online and in the recording studio. And we'll be back making music together before you know it. Music City Roots is a production of Hang Dye Media, executive producers John Walker and Todd Mayo. For Jim Lauderdale, Craig Havokhurst, and the whole Roots family, good night from Music City.
Love is but a song to sing, fear's the way to die. The mountains ring, or make the angels cry. Though the bird is on the wing, you may not know why. Come on, people now, smile on your brother, everybody get together. Shall surely pass. When the one that left us here turns to us at last, we are but a moment's sunlight fading in the grass. Get together, try to love one another right now.
Just one key unlocks them both. There it's your command. Come on, people now. Smile on your brother. Everybody get together. Try to love one another right now. Come on, people now.
So much.
Hang tight.